डियर स्टूडेंट्स, कॉलेज में हमने सिलेजिनेला कंप्लीट किया था, कई अब हम ऑनलाइन मोड ऑफ पढ़ रहे हैं, उसके अंदर मैं अब स्टार्ट करने जा रहा हूं इक्विस्टम। इक्विस्टम इज ए टेरिडोफाइट्स। ये फर्स्ट आपके फर्स्ट पेपर की सेकेंड यूनिट में जो टेरिडोफाइट्स थे उनके अंदर ये जेनरा है, दैट इज द इक्विस्टम। इक्विस्टम इज ऑल्सो नोन एज द होस्ट। Equisetum is the single living genera that are present in the division Spinophyta. The Spinophyta are the plant, pteridophytes plant, which have the stem is jointed. The stem is jointed and they are differentiated into node and internodes. And the internodes of these stem have possess longitudinally leaves and the furrows. These characters are found in the Equisetum. So, Equisetum is the single living genera of the division Spinophyta. The species, total 25 species are found in all over the world of Equisetum. In which most common that are found in Indians are the Equisetum arvens, Equisetum devils and Equisetum diffusums. Because it is a pteridophyta, so the main plant body of the sporophyte. The sporophyte plant, sporophytic, that produce the spores. And there are the pteridophytes, so they have the vascular bundles. So pteridophyte means first vascular bundles plants. Main plant body of the Equisetum is the sporophytic. The main plant body Equisetum is divided into the root, stem and leaves. The stem of Equisetum is the found in the soils. There are node aerials, it is found in the soil. It is known as the rhizome. Rhizome are the horizontals parallel to the soil of stems. It is brown in colors and it is node. It originates the aerial branches and the root. Because it is the found in the division of Spinophyta, so their stem is divided into node and internodes. Many reeds and furrows are found in the internodes. This is the characteristic feature of the Equisetum, that their stem is have node and internodes, and their internodes have the longitudinally furrow and the ribs. From the internodes, many aerial branches and root are originated. The aerial branches are two types. It is the sertile branches and it is the fertile branches. In some species both are same, but in many species, that is the Equisetum arvens, the sterile and fertile branches are the separate to each other. The sterile branches are originate from to the node of the rhizomes. The number of primordials are equal to the number of the reeds or furrow of the stems. The aerial branches is also divided into the node and internodes. And the many lateral branches also originate from the node part of the aerial branches. The node have the sheath of leaves. I can explain that the leaf of Equisetum is not involved in the photosynthesis. The leaf of Equisetum is the scale leaves, and at the base of the leaf is jointed and form the seed. And these seeds are covered the node. And the number of leaf is equal to the number of the rays that is found on the stem or aerial branches. The many branches primordials are originate from the nodes, and the number of branches primordials is the equal to the scale leaves. So this is the rhizomes, this is the aerial branches, this is the root. Now I explain that is the aerial branches. Aerial branches two types. That is the sterile branches and fertile branches. The fertile branches is not divided against and it has a apical of cone. Cone is the reproductive portion of the equisetums. Root is originate from the rhizomes, a lower part of the rhizomes. The root is adventitious root. Not the primary roots are found. The primary roots are ephemerals and it is early stage it is destroyed and a new adventitious roots are originate from the endogenously from the lower portions. These roots are branched, have root caps and they fix the equisetum plant in the soils. Sometimes the branch primordials in the rhizomes are converted into a asexual reproductive parts that is called the tubers. These tubers are involved in the asexual reproduction of the equisetums. So at last I can now explain, this is the rhizome, this is the aerial branches, this is the leaves and these are the roots. These are the external morphology of the equisetum. The main characteristic feature of the equisetum has the intercalary meristems. Intercalary meristems are found the just above the nodes and it is involved in the longitudinal division of aerial branches. So, ये intercalary meristem है, ये इसका characteristic feature होता है. ये intercalary meristem जो होता है, वो इसके node के just ऊपर पाया जाता है. और ये intercalary meristem regularly divide होके इसको लंबाई में वृद्धि करवाता है. ये जो intercalary meristem है, ये चारों ओर से leaf seed से गिरा रहता है. तो इसलिए हमने आज आपको बताया that is first इसका जो स्टेम होता है वो लोंगिट्यूडिनली होता है. स्टेम जो होता है वो सोइल के अंदर होता है और राइजोम होता है. स्टेम जो है वो नोड और इंटरनोड में डिवाइड होता है. इससे एरियल ब्रांचेस और रूट्स निकलती है. जो एरियल ब्रांचेस हैं ये दो तरह की होगी, दैट इज द स्ट्राइल एंड फर्टाइल. जिनके ऊपर कोन लगा होता है दैट इज द स्ट्राइल ब्रांचेस एंड जिन पर कोन नहीं लगता दैट इज द जिन पर कोन लगा होता है दैट इज द फर्टाइल्स और जिन पर कोन नहीं लगा होता दैट इज द स्ट्राइल ब्रांचेस. स्ट्राइल ब्रांचेस जो होती है वो और आगे डिवाइड होती है. एक और है दैट इज द लीफ ऑफ द इक्विस्टम आर नॉट इन्वॉल्व इन द फोटोसिंथेसिस. The photosynthesis is done by the stems. Equisetum में जो leaves जो होती है वो scaly leaf होती है, small होती है और इसका जो function होता है उसका function only the protect of the node and the intercalary meristem and node is the photosynthesis. The photosynthesis is occurred by the stem of the equisetum. So this is the external morphology of the equisetum. Tomorrow we can explain the internal morphology of the equisetum.